Viewers. So in previous video, we had studied about CDNs. In this video, we will be talking about case studies. So firstly, Netflix. So as for report for 2011 in US internet, it generates 30% downstream traffic. So Netflix is that much big and it is using leading service provider for online movies and TV shows. To expand, it uses third party. As we had seen previously, Akamai CDN is used for Netflix and third-party cloud services and CDNs. It does video distribution using CDN and uses Dash technology. So for streaming, Netflix uses Dash technology. Now it needs four components for video distribution. So as you can see that in this diagram, there are four components. One for registration and payment servers. One is Amazon Cloud, another is CDNs. So these four components, one is client. Okay, so firstly, client, if he want to send, see the video or watch the video on Netflix, he firstly has to register and give the payment for the service. So it will be done in registration and payment servers. After the registrations are done, it will be sent to the Amazon Cloud directly. So for distributing the videos, Netflix firstly has to ingest its videos before releasing to the customers. It has to ingest its videos to Amazon Cloud. Now Amazon Cloud will be processing all the videos given by the Netflix. And as you can see that it creates different formats of same video. So here different formats for same video will be created and then are being served to the CDNs or clusters. From that clusters, client can probe the video chunks. So chunks are 4 second long, and while user is seeing or watching the video, rate determination algorithm will be running, and it will be running for determining the quality up to which or to extent the quality is supported by the client's machine. Now case study about YouTube. So as you all know that a 500 million videos library and 500 million views per day is supported by YouTube, and it is of course world's largest video sharing site, and it started in 2005 and is a subsidiary of Google. And as like Netflix, YouTube also uses CDN technology, but in Netflix it is using third-party services for CDN. In YouTube, Google has its own CDNs, so it is not using third-party servers. So as they are having their own private CDN servers, they are not using third-party resources. Now Google has several CDN clusters on which it distributes YouTube videos. The CDN with lowest RTT, means return trip time, is being chosen to serve the client. So this is cluster selection strategy. And if cluster doesn't have requested video, it sends HTTP redirect message to whom? To that cluster or server which is having video or requested video from the client. And as you all know that client to server upload is also possible on YouTube. So it is also done in same way as YouTube is giving the videos to Google servers. So YouTube process each video, converting in YouTube format and in different versions, and then serving is done. In contrast with Netflix using third-party services, YouTube uses its own servers to serve the users. So in this slide, we will be talking about case study Kankan. So unlike Netflix and YouTube, as they are using TCP, now they are using P2P delivery instead of client server architecture. So there we are using client server architecture. Here we are using peer-to-peer network. Now they are widely used in China, similar to working of BitTorrent. And here to get the video, the user firstly has to register with the tracker in the network or P2P network. So tracker to discover other peer in the system that have a copy of that video. Now this peer then requests chunks of video file in parallel from these other peers that have the file. So he will request the video file from other peers which are lying in the network. Different from downloading with BitTorrent, as it requests chunks that are to be played back in near future. So while requesting the video, it is requesting some more bytes of video for the future playback, employs trackers and its own DHT for tracking content. Now DHT means distributed hash table. So here Kankan has to maintain a distributed hash table for the video, or to get the track of the video in which peer as video is present. So for that DHT are used, and Kankan protocols for communication between peers and tracker, peer and DHT and among peers are all proprietary. So they are owned by Kankan, and it uses UDP when possible. So inside China, it is using UDP type of traffic. So in next video, we will be talking about network support for multimedia. Till then, thank you.